Hey fellow tacticians, be sure to like this video and subscribe and ring that little notification bell that supports this channel's conservative content, which is good for me, good for you, good for America, but really bad for the dark cyber overlords at YouTube.
Hey, where are you going, champ? Slugger?
Hey, cowboy!
Where are you going?
Where are you going?
I'm going out!
Hey everybody, it's Caleb here, and I'm coming to you heading south on I-65. I was thinking about the recent expansion of Amtrak, which of course is federal government subsidized public transportation in the form of trains, and being on the road, I just kind of contrasted that to driving your own personal vehicle. I thought about the reason that people on the left tend to favor public transportation, and the reason that people on the right tend to favor private transportation, like owning your own vehicle. Pickup trucks, jeeps, motorcycles, whatever you may want to drive. And I thought about how this really illustrates the difference in those two philosophies in a lot of ways. For one, it really boils down to individualism. I mean, in a way, your vehicle is an expression of who you are. Some of you may have a pickup truck because it helps you with work. Some of you may have a delivery van because you're in some kind of occupation where you deliver things. Some of you may have any number of different cars and have them customized with certain paint jobs or certain decals, because ultimately it's an expression of who you are. That doesn't happen with public transportation. Everybody's on the same cart that looks exactly the same as every other cart. And when it comes to Amtrak, besides them just hemorrhaging money and besides it being a favorite transportation of people in urban areas, ultimately, I think the reason that people on the left just sort of fundamentally favor public transportation a lot more is because it doesn't treat people like individuals. Is there any greater expression of freedom than owning your own vehicle, learning how to drive, getting your license at 16, and basically having the world as your oyster? I mean, you can jump out anytime you want to. If you want to wake up at 2 a.m. and jump on your motorcycle and just take off into the blue, or I guess at that time of day into the black, that's your business. It's up to you. You do it when you want to. It works around your schedule. That doesn't happen with public transportation. With public transportation, you have to show up when they tell you to show up, get on the train when they tell you to get on the train. It goes at a set miles per hour. It plans out the trip exactly, and it can't go anywhere else other than where it was already designated because it's on tracks. It literally can't go anywhere other than staying on the line that government set out for it at its onset. And I think that that's kind of the way that people on the left view people too. They want government to lay out a track for you, and you get on when they tell you to get on, you get off when they tell you to get off, and basically everything is planned ahead of time. It's not like having your own vehicle where if you are in an off-road vehicle like a Jeep, you jump in your Jeep and you don't even have to stay on the road if you want to. You can just drive out into the middle of nowhere. If you're in a pickup truck, you can just drive out in the middle of a pasture. If you are on a dirt bike, then you can do that. I mean, there's no greater symbol of freedom than being on the open road. And that's why I think people on the right tend to favor it more. In a lot of ways, it is one of the most American signs of liberty that we have in our culture. And ultimately, the left just doesn't like individualism or liberty, and that's why they'd rather have your government-issued standard public transportation that requires you to stay in the lines and work off their schedule and do things according to their plan. The right just wants you to be able to essentially do what you want. This is usually the part of the video where I ask you to like this video and subscribe to my show and click the notification bell. Does that guarantee you're going to get notifications when I post new content? Honestly, the way that YouTube censors conservatives, I really doubt it. But you know what liking and subscribing does do, for sure? It ticks off the dark cyber overlords at Google when they see those likes and subscriptions despite shadow banning my conservative content. So you really should like and subscribe, if nothing else, just to stick it to them.